The Steelers drafted Najee Harris in the first round last year to turn around something that was one of the worst running attacks, if not the worst running attack in football last season, but it didn't really work. They were the fourth worst team in both total rushing yards and rushing yards per carry, so it wasn't what they expected. Now, was this all on the offensive line, or was a little bit of this on Najee Harris? If you've listened to me talk on Twitter and TikTok and the podcast over the past week or so, you've heard me talk a little bit about how I think some of this is on Najee. But I hadn't really done a deep dive into this, so I wanted to see if the film backed up what I thought while looking at stats and just watching the game from the broadcast angle. So this is my deep dive into Najee Harris's rookie season. I wanted to use games against bad defensive lines, because it's true, they do have a bad offensive line. So in games where they were clearly overmatched, I don't know how much you can take away from that. I wanted to look at games against the Lions and the Chargers and some other games against equally bad defensive lines, so they would have some sort of chance. Let's get one thing clear, crystal clear, before anything else. The main problem with Steelers' running game is their offensive line. It's really bad. If they had a good offensive line and Najee Harris was the running back, they would have a really good run offense. Najee Harris is not going to sabotage a good offensive line. But just most of the time, the offensive line is bad, and Najee can't really elevate it, I guess is what I'm saying. But anyway, here's one example of there just being nothing there. Najee's going to follow the pulling guard here, and where he'd like to go is through this gap right here between the tight end and this pulling guard, but they're too close together. There is no crease, and obviously you can't go through there or bounce this outside. So what Najee does, I think, is actually pretty smart. He tries to put his foot in the ground and hesitate and give these guys a little bit more time to drive their defenders out of the way before Najee hits it. But, you know, he gives them that little bit of extra time. They can't create anything, and there's just nowhere for him to go. There's nothing anybody could do about that. Here's another example. It looks like the Steelers are running outside zone, and when Najee gets the ball here, what gap is open? There isn't one. So he bounces this outside and does a nice job getting what he can from this. But it is important, although I have my problems with Najee Harris, which I'll get into, that prevent me from putting him as like a top 10 running back, it is important for you to know that I recognize the majority of the Steelers' problems come from their offensive line. And honestly, I came away from this process a little bit more impressed with Najee's vision than I thought I would be. Like this play, for example, they're going to run the same play as I just showed you, but this time, like, this nose tackle falls on the ground and they do a little bit job reaching these guys and giving Najee more gaps to run through. The interior defensive lineman, number 53, doesn't quite reach that linebacker, but Najee understands that once he clears this gap and is able to cut this back around inside instantly and pick up, like, you know, maybe 10 yards after that, break some ankle tackles. However, some of the inefficiencies of the Steelers running game was on Najee. It wasn't all on the offensive line. Look, you do not need that big of a crease to create an explosive play. If you really put your head down and hit a hole hard, some of them are going to just break big. As you can see from the Lions backup, Godwin Igwebute here, I think his name is, right? You'll see them run that kind of same sort of outside zone. You see this gap open up in between those two. And then he puts his head down and he's just like, I'm just going to hit it as hard as I can, run straight, and then try to make the safety miss, which he does. And that's a longer run than Najee Harris had all season. I don't think Najee always puts his head down and just is like, screw it, I'm just going through this. This play is a really good example of that. You're going to watch this three tech and the Mike linebacker really overcommit outside here. As soon as this play snaps, they go flying that way once they see the play developing that way. And then Najee cuts it back, and the only dude really there on the defensive line is this dude. And Najee does a nice job setting him up and juking him out, and there's no one out in front of him here. Everyone's sealed off over here. The only dude he has to worry about is this guy chasing him from the backside. But as soon as he clears that guy, and I think he's got a lot of room to just put his head down and run forward and maybe break an arm tackle here, and then it's just a safety. But as soon as he clears that, where does his eyes go and where does his head go? To this guy. And he's thinking, oh, I gotta juke him out. And so he puts his foot in the ground and moves laterally when I think he's got a lot of space if he just keeps running forward. I think this is just an arm tackle from this backside linebacker if that's what he chooses to do, but no. Once he clears this, he tries to cut this back to the left, and it gets tackled for basically no gain. This is another decent example of that to me. It looks like they're running inside zone here, and immediately that B gap opens way up, and Najee's clearly looking right at it, and it seems like that's where he's got to go, and you want to hit that hard and see if you can get enough momentum to break some tackles here. But when he gets the ball, he squares his feet up. They're parallel to the line of scrimmage. He stutters them for a while, and it just slows him down, and I don't think he needs to do that. And then by the time he hits that hole and actually accelerates through it, that gap is closed substantially, and it's not as big of a gain as it could have been. Here's another example. It looks like, to me, the A gap is pretty open here, and he hits it, but he doesn't put his head down and just run forward. He's got to be a little bit too cute and try to bend this back, and trips over his tackle, or his center, I guess, in the process. And again, I don't think this run goes for as long as maybe it would for other running backs. And no one can say that the offensive line didn't give him a crease here. The Moses parting the seas is what this is like. A big gap to run through. Gets him one-on-one with the safety, and I just don't think he has the speed or explosiveness or talent as a pure runner to make him really dangerous, or one of the most dangerous in the league in these situations. One-on-one with the safety. Chops his feet, slows up, tries to juke him out and win around the outside, but it doesn't matter, and he gets wrapped up. Is probably the best one to conclude with when talking about his flaws, because I think it's the number one undeniable obvious example of what I'm talking about here. They're running like an insert zone where the tight end is going to come in and take the linebacker tranquil here, and Najee just simply has to cut up field more here. There's the gap. These two are accounted for here, and Najee just doesn't want to take it, and he cuts this outside and starts running backwards, basically, instead of following the play as it's designed and following his lead blocker. And you know this is his fault, because watch Big Ben. Cut up field, yelling at him. You got to bring that up field. And Najee knows it, right? First, when he gets tackled, he gets up like, oh, that was a mistake. My bad. And then there's Ben telling him to cut up field. So he needs to do that more. Now, I think he can get better at this as his offensive line improves, as he gets more confident with it, as he gets more time in the league. But I don't think he's ever going to be a really good explosive running back. Like, this is his explosive play rate in college. It's well below a lot of the other running backs drafted in the last 2 years. So if he wasn't an explosive running back in college, and no one can say that he didn't have a good offensive line there, and then he came into the NFL and had a really low rate of explosive plays compared to the amount of carries that he got, I just don't think he's ever going to be a guy who breaks off, you know, long runs or is a home run hitter over and over again. But on the flip side, on the bright side, this probably isn't as bad of a thing as I've made it sound, because this is Ezekiel Elliott's career, and he's never been good at creating explosive plays and breaking off long runs over and over again. And yet still, he's been one of the most dominant, successful running backs that we've seen over the past couple years here. Le'Veon Bell is another guy like this. He hasn't had an explosive run in like 5 years. He hasn't had one since 2017. But even in his prime, he wasn't that good at creating them. And in his prime, he was still a top one, top two, top three running back. He was still an efficient running back. And no one's going to deny that. And I think Najee Harris can have the type of career that Le'Veon Bell had. And I think he can have the type of prime that Zeke Elliott had. And no one is going to say that those guys weren't elite running backs in their prime. Najee does a lot of things well. Watch in shock and awe as he receives this checkdown and kills Jonathan Abram with his brutal stiff arm. He's really strong and picks up a couple more yards after the spin move. He's got great hand-eye coordination. He's a great receiving threat. He doesn't drop passes, he doesn't fumble, and ankle tackles don't really bring him down. And although I think that he lacks home run speed, in the open field, he's got a lot of agility for a guy his size, a lot of lateral movement, and his strength. It makes him really tough to bring down once he starts to get going. So don't totally brand me as some Najee Harris hater, all right? I do think that he's good. I'm just here to tell you that part of the reason why the Steelers' running game was as inefficient as it was on him. It wasn't 100% the offensive line. Now, another thing is, like, some of the guys I listed, like Tony Pollard or A.J. Dillon or Rashad Penny, I think as pure runners with the ball in their hands, like the talent they've got, is still above Najee. I would still say that, but they're just never really going to get the workload that Najee has gotten because they're not as durable and they're not as well-rounded, and they're not as good at pass blocking, where Najee really does truly shine. He is a really good pass blocker, and you can keep him on the field for all three downs, and that's just not the case with other running backs, even if they are better runners. So, in conclusion, to answer the question this video poses, how good is Najee Harris? He's pretty good. He's pretty good. I think he's going to be a little bit overrated as a pure runner in his career because he's going to have the volume stats, but those volume stats come because he can contribute on all three downs. And he finished in the negatives this year for rushing yards over expectation. He was 31st in yards created per touch. He was 151st in EPA. He was 33rd in breakaway run rate and 49th in yards per carry. So it's not like he was not super efficient this year. He was not super, super great as a pure explosive ball carrier, which I've said a million times. I'm repeating myself at this point, but he is a pretty good running back, and he is better than those stats indicate. So some people who just look at those are going to really underrate him, and some who just look at the raw production are going to kind of overrate him, I feel like. That's the same way I felt with Zeke over these past couple of years, and it's the same way I felt about Le'Veon Bell. Not maybe all-time greats because they don't have that dynamic ability that some of the other guys do, but solid running backs and can be a running back committee all by themselves, which not a lot of running backs can be nowadays. So those are my overall thoughts on Najee Harris. I hope both Steelers fans and non-Steelers fans alike can find this video fair and back up what maybe they see on film and be kind of a happy compromise for all parties involved here. So thank you so much for watching. I will be back next week with another film review on a player I have not decided yet. So let me know in the comments what kind of video you'd like to see. I've done running backs, quarterbacks, safety, defensive line, and wide receiver so far. So I'm getting down there on all the positions, which I'd like to. That's a goal I've set for myself. So again, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you later.